Good morning, everyone. Today we'll discuss about the longest common subsequence. It is an example for dynamic programming problem. So it is an algorithm which is used to find the optimum solution. In this, what we are doing is dynamic programming. Why do we use dynamic programming means, the reason is to find the optimal solution of the problem. In this, what we have to do is we have to divide the problem into several sub problems first. At that stage, we will know that how many parts it can be divided and how many sequence it can be taken. Once all the parts or all the sub problems is solved one after the other, and the optimal solution for each part is taken first. After that, what we are going to do is the optimal solutions are made from each part. We're going to add everything and we find that the optimal solution of each sub problem will be the optimal solution of the main problem. That's why we divide the given problem into a different sub problems, and then we'll find the optimal solution for each sub problem and we'll combine everything. At that case, we'll find the optimal solution of the whole problem. It is an longest common subsequence is the example for that kind of problem. So in the definition, it is given that it is finding the longest subsequence present in given two sequence in the same order. In the same order, we'll be given two sequences. In that sequences, we'll find the longest subsequence of that given two sequence. That is, find the longest sequence which can be obtained from the first original sequence by deleting. What we do this, for example, if there is eight letter word, which means A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, like that, eight letter word is given. In that eight letter word, and we'll have the second sequence same like that. In the given two sequences, what we are going to do is we'll be adding some and we'll be deleting some items which is not needed. It is done in this longest common subsequence. So for example, it is given here, X and Y are two sequences of the finite set of elements. It is which means it can be 8 or 9, which is countable. So we can say that the Z is the common sequences. For example, let me tell you, we'll take a sequence called A, B, C and D. In that A, B, C and D, the subsequence can be A, B or B, C or C, D like that. We'll find many, if it is a four, we have taken the sequence of four word, four letter A, B, C and D. In this, what we have to do is we have to calculate how many subsequences can be taken. In that, how do we find that is, it is given in this 2 power m. In this 2 power m, what we're going to do is, how do we gonna find it is, if we have A, B and C and D, we have four letter. In that, what we gonna do is the 2 power m, which is number of letter in it, that is 2 power 4, we have to calculate. But it is not possible if the sequence is very big, if we have 16 or 17 like that. In that sequence, it is not possible for us to calculate. 2 power 16 is impossible, it will take more time. So what we gonna do is to find this common sequence, which is a longest common sequence. In A, B, C, D, the longest common sequence is C and D. It may be C, D or A, B or A, C, A, B, C as well. So to find that, following this name method, that is 2 power m method, it is not possible and it is very tiring. So it is given as it will take off 2n into 2 power m of time. So to find this longest common sequence, we'll have another example to discuss this. In we have the first sequence called as A, C, A, D, B here, and the second sequence as C, B, D, A. It is a finite which is countable here. So we will have 4 to 5 steps which will be followed one after the other. So in the first step, what we have to do is we have to create a table. So I've taken this X sequence, this sequence here, horizontally, see here, I'm sorry, vertically, A, C, A, D, B. And in horizontally, we have taken the y-axis, this y-axis, that is C, B, D, and A. In this matrix, we have filled here with 0 of first row and first column. That means it is something which is called as that n cap. We use that n cap or something, we can use it. Just it is not denote that all the first element, which is of starting element, will be always of 0. So it is written that 0. So for this, you can give any symbol over here. So we'll have that negotiation symbol also as well as here. So what we do is it is filled with 0. The first column and the first row is filled with 0. So be careful while filling it, because see, there is an empty space over here and also over here. If you write CBDA continuously, if you fill this 0 and 0, we will not be able to find the max longest sequence here. So make sure that you are clear that this each column and each row, they will have an empty row and empty column that is filled with 0. So first step, what we're doing is, it is the first table of dimension is n plus 1 star of m plus 1. That is, this is calculator of x and y respectively. The first row and the first column are filled with zeros. Yeah. And then we have two cases. One case is, let me tell you, A and C, which is different. Here in this case, A and C will be different. When A and C is different, we will have one case. And if A and here the two cases, we have the same letter. In this case, what we'll do is we will follow the another case. First one, if the character corresponding to a current row and current column are matching. In this case, what? It is A and A. In this case, what will we do is, then fill the current cell by adding 1 to the diagonal element. So in this case, A to A, if you take, for example, it will take A and A. In this A and A, here it is 0. Here it is also 0 and here also is 0. In this case, what we have to do is, we have to add 1 plus of this diagonal value. See the arrow here? It is given like this. So that is 1 plus of this diagonal value. It is mentioned that it is diagonal. Only diagonal element is taken in this case. So in this case, what it is, 1 plus 0, that is 1 is written over here. And in this case, in the second case, it is given that A and C. We'll take, for example, I'll take A and C. In this case, what we have to do is, these elements are different. So we have to see this element and this element. In this, we have to take the maximum number. Here, it is both the side, it is 0. So I have taken 0 here. So in each and every step, you have to write this arrow from where it is taken. In this place, we have taken this 0 plus 1. So the arrow is drawn diagonally. In this case, what they have done is, in this example, they have taken this 0. I told you that you can take the maximum element of this two boxes, that is one from the top and or from the left. In this case, they have taken this 0 because both are same. It has the same number. So this 0 is taken. So they have given the arrow like this. It is not that only this 0 should be taken. We can also take this 0 as well. If I take this 0, what we have to do is, we have to draw the arrow to the left, a left cell. So if that is A or C, if the elements are different, what we have to do is, we have to see this element from the top and this element from the left. We have to take the maximum number of these two and we have to write it over here in this block. This will be the element for A and C. See, else take the maximum value from the previous column or the previous row for filling the current cell. Point an arrow to the cell with the maximum value. Where do we take the maximum value? From that maximum value, we have to draw an arrow. If they are equal, then point to as many of them. If it is 0 and 0, whichever you want, you can take. So if in the case, in the step 2, what we have done is, it is of same case. And if the, in the step 3, what we have done is, if the values are different, we have done this. So we have to go on repeating the same. If you see this example here, the 0 is taken here. Now we'll compare A and B. In this comparison, they have taken, you have to check this one and this one, and they have taken this 0. Then we'll take A and D. In this case, they have taken the number from the upper column. And then here, we already calculated that we have to add this 1 plus this diagonal element. So the same. So if we come for C, C and C is the same. In this case, what happened? They have added 1 plus this diagonal element and the arrow is drawn for that cell. And this is continued one after the other. Then finally, what we have done is, we have got this element. So the last cell of this box, that is the last row or the last column, the last element will be the longest subsequence for the given two set of sequence CBDA and ACADB. The longest common subsequence will be made of only two elements. It may be CB or DA or AC or AD or DB. There will be only two elements in that sequence. So for example, see, the value in the last row and the last column is the length of the longest common sequence. The length will be only of two. this example. So then the next step, so we have to go and repeat it until we find the last element. Once the last element is found, in order to find the longest common sequence, start from the last element and follow the direction of the arrow. The corresponding to the symbol form the longest common sequence. Let me explain this view. First, here it is 2. We have to start from this column. Here the arrow is upward. The arrow is upward. So we have to find the root first, and then only we will be able to find the sequence. So it is 2 here. It goes upwards. No problem. We're not going to change anything or write anything. 2 here. And again, it is upward. So 2 is, in this case, it is 2 here. And then the arrow moves diagonally into the next cell. So when the arrow moves diagonally, what we have to do is the element from which cell you are moving diagonally. You have to check that this is from this element, it is moving diagonally. In this case, we have to see the row and the column. In this case, both are same. So we'll write A. A will be the element, one of the elements. So let me show you. A will be our first element. And then if the, for example, here it is, since it is A and A, you have written A. So in this case, when it is A and B, when it comes A or C or A or D, in A and D, which will be the greater element? If it is D written here, then D will be greater. D is greater than A, right? So the D will come in that place. So now it is same A and A, so I've written A. Once it is written, and then what we'll do is it is moved upward, and then from this cell it is moved to the left. The arrow is left, so no changes and nothing will be written. And again it is left, so nothing will be written. Then it goes diagonally here. The arrow goes diagonally in this place. So what we have to do is from which cell it is moving, diagonally, we have to check it. Here it is from this cell. So what we are gonna do is we'll see the corresponding value for it, that is C and C. Since it is same, what will we write is we will write C over here, and then it comes to the zero. Okay, and then I said if the value is moved to left, if it is moved to left, and if there is any changes, then the sequence may change. But in this example, the arrow is moved upward. So for us, the sequence is, the longer sequence is made of only 2, because the element here is 2. If it is 4 here, what will we do is, the sequence will be of 4 letter, that is C, B, D, A. In this example, if we take that, it may be C, B, D, A, or A, C, A, D, B, like that. So in here, only 2. So we'll find only 2 of the sequence. So the longest common subsequence for the given number of sequences is C and A. So like this, we will let us solve in the next class about if there are any changes in this arrow, what happens? If it moves left, it may come to this place. And if it is moved left, it can come in this place. Now, if it is left, so what will we do here? So it moves top now. It moves diagonally to the one element. So we have to write the sequence called this one, B and B. So our sequence will be B. And now if it is 1, from 1, it moves upwards, and it comes to the 0 here. So our sequence will be here again. It is from the diagonally, it is moved. So our sequence will be C and C. So it is not that one, you have to check only when if it is moved diagonally. So the arrows should be properly marked wherever it is diagonally moved. If you take, you can also take the upperward arrow, or it is left side arrow. But when if it has 2 numbers as same value, here also 1, here also 1. But in this case, this 1 is taken. You can also take the 1 from this place. Once when you change the order of the arrow, the sequence may also change. But here I have taken the arrow upward. Everywhere I have used the arrow upward. Since it is used upward, my sequence is C and A. Thank you.
Gracias.